this time my mic is not muted, so that's always very helpful. So I just, this is a demo, I guess, of the software. And it just does, it does the things I'd normally have to do manually. It just does it automatically by pressing these buttons right here, or pressing these keys. I just press the key for the function. And I should be able to demonstrate these functions during this session. So, you know, it can all be done on paper. It can all be done, you know, using Notepad or whatever. I mean, you don't have to have this. It doesn't doesn't give any advice or anything. It just tracks things and makes it easier to do it. So, I'll just go ahead and start spinning. This is immediately after this massive downswing that we had, and I recovered off of it. This is like the next spin. This last spin, this number two that hit, you can't see, it's on the number two hit. That was the last number to hit, and that put me up here at 516.82. So let's just go ahead and spin out and see what happens. All right, and we got hit on number three. So it wants to know the balance. So I put that in, and then it logs it. See, it just tells you what spin number. Number three hit on spin one, and there's the balance at the time that it hit. And so that's nice. And now I'm going to spin out to spin five on the progression. Hit the miss key, and it just advances everything. Now we're going out to spin 9. Okay. So now here comes expectation. Right here. Well, actually that was expectation for the first spin. For the first hit. So now we're going to start moving into the next deviation level or whatever. We're no longer in like deviation per se. 9 and 4 is 13. So right, same thing as 12 plus 1. Okay. So yeah. So still approaching actual expectation for this hit. Okay, and last spin. Oh, the zero. Yeah. Okay. So 517.08. So yeah. Whatever. It doesn't actually matter what I do here, I guess. I'm not gonna, I'll just put that in as the all-time high. So I hit the A, I hit the A key for the all-time high, and it asks for the balance. So now it's up there. And then I hit the R key to reset, and it just resets it. And so it's just, you know, I can just hit keys instead of having to type in Notepad. I mean, it's really what it comes down to. And it's all conveniently done. So let's see if we can get some kind of recovery or something here. Okay, that was number one. So 517.16. Yep, there it is. We're gonna go out to spin number six. So I just keep the perspective immediate. Wow, number two. Okay, so 517. 34. Okay. And I'm going to keep going. So, going out to spin 9. I'm going because there's space in the progression. Whoa. Zero's on fire. So, 517.52. So whatever, I'll just log it. It doesn't really matter. 5, 6, 17, 52. reset. Just way too many hits in a succession, so it does kind of matter in the sense that I'm just allowing more spins to play out now because I'm coming back 8 spins on the counter and starting over. I mean, I make decisions based on the spin number, so I'm just resetting my perspective, and let's just see where we're at. What is it going to do with regards to the expectation? How are we looking at with the expectation? And that's, I just try to pay attention to what the wheel's doing at the moment and get information that way. So now we go out to spin 8. All right. And so we're going to go out to spin 12. Here's an expectation will be in this section here. That spin, that's expectation. So of 11 and 12. So, okay. And now we'll see if we can get into a standard deviation here. I mean, we've had some good variance, obviously. 14. Okay, number 1. And so 5, 17, 28. So, I mean, we've taken a little hit. We come back 9, we're at spin 6. So I'll just go back to 2. So I'll just go back to 2. And, just a slightly up in the progression. And spin forward. So we're going to go out to spin 19. Hopefully we get a nice hit and get some profit. 18. And there's 19. So that's expectation right there. So let's see what happens. Going out to 23. We'll get a standard deviation in 5 spins after that. 2. 3. Okay. So let's see what happens here. Going out to spin 27 now. Whoa, okay. So number 1 hit. That's 5, 17, 20. Down a little bit further now. So okay. So now, I'm already out at spin 25. I'm looking probably at some sleeping situations going on with these 3 numbers. So I'm going to reset the, I'm going to create a new level. So this is how the recovery system works. You hit N to make a new level. So I'm going to go to level 2. So I'm going to hit N. It asks for the balance. So I just put in the balance. Okay, and then it records it. See, it shows it right here. And it writes to the output file, you're doing this. And so now I can see where I hit level 2, what my goal, where I started at in level 2. And then I'm going to reset the session. And now I'm going to start betting with 2 units because I'm on level 2. And this should work out pretty nice, hopefully. Let's see. Just see what happens. There we go. So 5, 17, 56. All right, that's an all-time high, but I'm going to gamble it. I'm only on spin 3 now, so I'm going to repeat this, and we're going to go out to spin 7. So that's what I'll do. Okay. So now we go to spin 11. See what it does. Wow. Okay, so 5, 18, 12. I like that a lot, so I'm just gonna keep going. I'm gonna gamble again. And got lots of space to, 27 spins. I think we're doing good on that. So I just keep going. Wow. Okay, so number two. That's one thing you don't want to do is hit the button after you get a hit. Make sure you don't have a hit when you hit the button. It gives you an extra spin. So anyway, it's 5, 18, 52 now. And I'll just that's an all-time high right there. So I'm gonna get rid of this level. So the way you get rid of a level is you hit X size. Okay, that removes the level entirely. Okay, and then I'm gonna hit all-time high. That's A key, and then put in the balance. So now it's at 5, 18, 52. And let me reset the session. That's how that works. And you know how you saw the down here it said level two, and then it had a number. Like if you hit the E key, you can actually put another number in there. Like sometimes what happens is you get some profit, okay, that you want to keep, but it's not an all-time high and it's not above the level that you were at, like where you hit the where you went into recovery, but it's higher. In other words, it's closer to getting recovered. It's higher than the original number, but it's not all the way recovered, and you want to reset the session. So what you do is you hit entry and you put in the balance, and that way you can see the progress. Like, like I dropped down here, if I was, at 517, and then I had 517.50, and then I wanted to reset, I would just hit entry. I would put in 517.50, so it would show that I had 50 units of profit. And then reset the session, and everything gets reset, and you can see the movement. Like it allows you to see the incline. And let me show you what I'm talking about. It's right about here. Okay, so this like for instance, from here to here, you went in, like we went into recovery here. We got this amount of profit. We log it, reset the session, and then we drop down to level three, say, so we can see what the incline was, and then we start a new level. We start level three, and it starts tracking it. So you can get an idea of how your recovery is going based on that, these level lo the lines of levels. So hope that makes sense. And you can delete an entry. Like if you put an entry in and you want to delete it, just hit the delete key. Sometimes you have entries, we put entries in that are lower. We still want to stay on the level, but we're lower than the previous entry. And then when we pass that, we want to delete that entry because it's no longer relevant because our balance is higher than that entry. And then we just hit delete and it deletes it. And then, so that's pretty much all the commands. New level to make one, entry to add an entry to the existing level. You can delete an entry if you put one in, and then you can get rid of an entire level by hitting the X key. So that's all the functionality. I'll just do one more spin through and see what happens. Let's see here. It's four spins. Number three. Okay, so that's 5, 18, 58. Yeah, it's an all-time high, but I'm going to keep going. Going out to spin seven. Ooh, zero again. Okay, so 5, 18, 76. I guess all the sleeping that, if you look at the t video, man, that. Those numbers were sleeping for a while, those main numbers, 0 and 2. Okay, so now we have 5, 18, 76. I'm going to keep going out to spin 10. Oh my gosh. So we have 5, 18, 94. Might as well gamble. We're gonna go four more. 13. Hope the 2 comes in is what I'm hoping for. Okay. So now we'll go out to 17. Okay. Coming up to expectation now. Okay, so we're going to go to 20. Right, that was expectation, and there's 20. Okay, so now we're getting into a little issue here. Gonna go to 24. We're probably gonna get some recovery out of this. 23 and 24. Okay, so here we are. 28. This will be one standard deviation. Oh no, it's not. This is no, actually, I forgot I had 3 hits. Anyway, let's keep going to 28. All right, number 3. Yeah, we're gonna take some damage. So 518, 44. So I'm gonna create a new level. Ippers and put in 518, 44. That's pretty bad, actually, but I guess I'm doing it. And then we hit recover and go to level 2 and spin 4 times. Hopefully number 2 comes in. 2. 3. And 4. Going out to spin 8, of course. Oh, man. Okay, let's see what happens here. Oh, no. Let's see here. Yeah. Hope I don't get a speeding ticket. Let's see. All right, so. All right, there you go. Number 1. So 518.44. So no change. So I'm gonna go back down and go out to spin 14. All right, there it is, number 2. And now we have 518.80. Okay. So I'm gonna get rid of this level, which is the X key. So bingo. All right, and I'll just log it. So this will be an all-time high. 518.80. I don't want to be going down to level 2 again. So I just log it and then reset. So that's pretty much how it all works. Little tired after all that recovery I was doing earlier. Plus it's getting later. So anyway, that'll be a demo video with actual where my mic is actually working. So thanks for watching.